Hello everyone and welcome back. This is Doc Ed Padama. Ngayon, pag-usapan natin kung paano madaling isulat itong tinatawag nating definition of terms ng inyong research. So, meron tayong sample research na ipapakita mamaya para makita ninyo kung paano ang application nitong discussion natin. So, unang sa lahat, itong definition of terms ay minsan merong ibang heading na ginagamit o ibang label. Isa na dyan yung tinatawag nating operational definition of variables. Pero pareho lang po ang laman at ang function nitong mga ito. Okay? So, pangalawa, this part of your research should start with an introductory statement. Ito na yung mga halimbawa ng introductory statement na pwede nyong gamitin. Pwede nyong i-adapt, i-paraphrase nyo na lang. So, una dyan, this part of the study presents the operational definition of the following terms. Or, pwede nyong gamitin yung the following are the terms used by the researcher in the study to have parallel understanding with the reader. So, ibig sabihin, para pareho ng understanding kung ano yung kahulugan ng term na yon, ginagamitan natin ng definition of terms. Pati yung parameter, halimbawa pag sinabi natin itong salitang ito, ang laman lang yan at ang sakop lang ng salitang yan ay hanggang dito. Yun ang tinatawag nating salitang operational. So when we say operational, lalong-lalo na operational definition, operational is how it was used. How it was used in the study. So kung paano nyo ginamit at kung ano yung kahulugan na inilagay ninyo, inassign ninyo doon sa salitang yon, doon sa research ninyo, that is what we call operational definition. So sana malinaw na sa inyo yon. Kasi meron tayong iba't ibang definition. Meron tayong conceptual definition based on how you understood the word, and then meron tayong lexical definition based on how it is defined sa dictionary or references or literary references. Next, number 3, all variables in the title, research title ninyo, should be reflected and included in the definition of terms. This is very important. Make sure that the variables reflected in your title, kung yan man ay strategy, issue, problem, pati yung respondents ninyo, should be included in the definition of terms. Do not forget that. That's the first terms or terms, term or terms that you will include in the definition of terms or operational definition of variables. Okay, yung susunod naman, other technical terms, technical words, meaning uncommon, unfamiliar terms that are pertinent, meaning important, and paulit-ulit na ginagamit sa research ninyo should also be included. Maliban sa variable. So halimbawa, meron kayong dalawa o tatlong variables. And then, aside from that, you also used terms na hindi familiar o hindi magiging familiar yung mga panel ninyo or readers ninyo. You should include that in your definition of terms. So maraming nagtatanong, ano po ba yung mga salitang isasama dito sa definition of terms? This is already the answer to that particular question. Okay, the next one, number 5, the definition of terms should be operationally and not conceptual or lexically defined. Okay, ulitin natin, the definition of terms should be operationally defined. It should be operational and not conceptual or lexical. Oh, so yun yung diniscuss natin kanina. When you say operational, how you used it in the research, kung paano nyo ginamit, yun ang definition na ilalagay ninyo dyan sa definition of terms nung salitang yon. Okay, next, number 6. The terms should be arranged alphabetically. So it's very fundamental. Make sure that you follow because some research writers still na-miss nila ito. I think it's just sometimes it's natural that you miss a term, but just make sure you do not mix all of them na they are not arranged alphabetically. Okay, because the panel would easily easily identify that. And then the next one, number 7, the minimum number of terms should be at least, this is recommendatory. So sometimes some institutions would say that as the need arises, it would depend on the number of terms that needs to be defined. So in order to set a standard mechanics for this particular part of your research, iset na natin siya a minimum of 5 to 8 terms inside this definition of terms. Okay, so basically, these are the reminders and the information that you need to be aware of kapag nagsusulat kayo ng tinatawag nating definition of terms. And then earlier, I said that I will show you an example of this. So let's just exit and then open this and go to page. Okay, I think it's in page 27. And then below this, you have the definition of terms. Okay, so remember what I told you earlier that sometimes they use the heading definition of terms. In this case, operational definition of variables is used. So take note of the position. It is centered. And then immediately after that will be the introductory statement. And then after that, you have the terms that were operationally defined in the study. So try to observe, are the terms arranged alphabetically? Okay, so you have inquiry, math. Okay, so they are arranged alphabetically. And then the number of terms used are, let us count. You have 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 5. So a maximum of 5 terms was used. And then the last one, which was not discussed earlier, is how you present the term. So this is a format that you may want to adopt. Okay, so the first one you try to observe, it is in bold. The letters are not in all caps. It is the standard capitalization, first letter. And then immediately after that, you have the period. Okay, so it is in bold, and then use the standard capitalization. And then you place a period after the term, and then immediately after that, you present the operational definition, which is supposed to be at least 1 to 2 sentences only. 1 to 2 sentences only. What does this mean? You do not need to place or use a very long definition. So go straight to the point and then place the definition in this part of your research. So it is as simple, as direct as this. So makikita nyo naman, yan ay title, introductory statement, and then you have 5 terms, the definition, and the format. So you are already done with this part of the research if you were able to follow this. So I hope you were able to again learn something from our discussion, and I hope you do implement and use this in your research writing. Marami pong salamat sa inyong lahat. Stay safe and God bless. Please help the channel by clicking subscribe and click the notification bell. Thank you very much. Goodbye.